I only shoot and score, then if you score, then we'll come.
Yo, what's up guys, Eki here. In every single NHL, I have a tradition to go over the top 5 versus teams in the game, in my opinion, and strictly on paper, here are all the teams that were very good, easily could be in the top 5, just personal preferences didn't make it to top 5. Number 5, easy to start off with my favorite team, the Toronto Maple Leafs. This team would be number 1 or number 2 on the list, if they would have a goaltender. Unfortunately, they don't anymore in this game. This is how I would do the lines with Toronto. Reason they are in the top 5. Offensive firepower is insane. They have great face of minus Spezza 85, Tavares 87. When I play with Toronto, I like to split a couple top guys into a couple lines, because you don't need to put Tavares, Marner and Matthews on the same line. That's just an overkill. Nice to get some balance on the lines. Defense is pretty good also. Nothing special, but gets it done. Reason they are only 5th, Mrazek and Campbell. Yeah, isn't getting it done in NHL games. Number 4, Tampa Bay Lightning. You guys are probably yelling at the screen, why is Tampa Bay only number 4? This is why. Only 3 right-handed forwards, Stamkos, Point, Perry. Stamkos is playing as a winger in real life. For some reason, he has an 86 face-off rating in this game. Offense, of course, is insane. But if Corey Perry is your 3rd best right-handed forward, things are not looking so good. Overall, high face-off ratings, but top 6 is all left-handed. In some players' list, this might be number 1. It's a very freaking stacked team. Defense again is very good, but here we go again. 3 right-handed defensemen, 83, 80 and 79 overall. Tampa Bay just has so much left-handed talent. It's kinda hard to create a balanced roster with Tampa Bay, but of course Tilla banger team and Vasilevski is here. Looking at the lineup again, could easily be higher, but again, when I was doing this lineup, I didn't really feel that good about it. Number 3, Philadelphia Flyers. Don't leave yet. We were talking about balance. Look at this lineup. Very balanced across the board. We have some solid players here. Couturier 89 faceoff. Chiru has 90 faceoffs. But again, Billy is lacking right-handed players. I kinda have to play him in the wing. And I would just split Chiru and Couturier in the special teams to have 2 high overall faceoff guys in separate lines. Maybe looking back on it, I would put Tampa higher. But at the same time, look at this defense. Best defense so far. And one of the best defense overall in NHL 22. Really no need to explain this. High overalls, good combination of big and fast players. And then, again, Philly could have been higher, but Carter Hart is in the net. Carter Hart is in the net, so that just isn't going to get it done. So Philly is number 3, and trust me, this is so even, man. I'm even changing minds about these teams when I'm going through this. Number 2, Dallas Stars. I feel like this is kind of an upgraded version of Philly. No star players though, but a lot of very high quality players. Radulov, Hintz, Seguin, Pavelski. You know what I'm talking about. Even Ben Gurianov, Robertson 84 in the 4th line. Glendening 3rd line center has 90 faceoffs. Perfect on the penalty kill or even on the power play. Again, they're lacking just a little bit of right-handed forwards. If I could run Seguin or Pavelski at center, this would be even better. Defense is very, very good. Klimber, Heiskanen, Lindell, Sutter. You could even split Heiskanen and Klimberg. Probably would be a smarter move. Lindell and Sutter are both a bit more defensive, so I would probably do something like this. 3rd line deeper lacks a bit. Yeah, this team is not perfect, but it's still a very high quality team overall. This team will not let you down. And Ben Bishop in net. Big reason why this team made it this high. 6'7". He's only an 85 overall now, but I still feel like he probably is very good in this NHL also. We don't know if the bigger goalies are still a meta, but I'm guessing they are. Number 1, Carolina Hurricanes. A team that got the number 1 place quite easily. Look at this roster on paper. Same as Dallas and Philly, very balanced offense, but now we have the couple stars. Aho 89, I played a couple games with Carolina. Aho is unreal. They finally put Aho's faceoff up as well. He has 81 faceoffs. Love to see that. Stahl has over 90 faceoffs also. They added Kotkaniemi. Nothing is missing from this team. Solid wingers, good combination of speed and size everywhere. Defense as well. Not the greatest, but very balanced. High quality defense. And they have Fredrik Andersen, who's always been a solid goal in NHL games. Internet as an 87 overall. So if we look at Carolina's roster overall, they have some star power, they have balance, absolutely zero weaknesses. Like I said, kinda easily at the number one spot. There we go, my top 5 versus teams in NHL 22. Like I said, keep in mind, this was very even. I had 14 teams written down on paper. And let's say the difference from my second best team to the 14th best team was very minor. Just personal preferences. It's nice to see NHL have so many usable teams nowadays. It's not like in the past where everybody played with Pittsburgh Penguins. One tiny change I would make to my list now, thinking again, I would probably have Tampa as the number 2 team. Even though they're not the most balanced roster, they're lacking right-hand players and everything, they still have way too many high overall players that can really win games for you. And the 92 Vasilevsky in internet is an X factor. No pun intended. Alright guys, thank you for watching. Let me know what your favorite teams are. What did you think about this list? Have a great day and see you next time.